This is an excerpt of a recent PowerUp webinar showcasing the new features in Apple Compressor and Final Cut Pro. Hi, my name is Larry Jordan. In this short video tutorial, I'll show you how to control what metadata is embedded into your movies during compression using Apple Compressor. This is a very useful technique when security or privacy are important. When we are looking at changing starting timecode, we're always adjusting the file. When we're dealing with metadata, we're adjusting the compression setting. So I'm going to take the compression setting and select it. And go to the General tab and scroll all the way down to the bottom. And this section is new, called Metadata. The default setting is to use job annotations and include metadata. But let me explain what these mean. Job annotations are set from compressor. So I'll select the job. There's our file here. Go to the job menu and go all the way down near the bottom. And we can see that there are job annotations. This allows me to say, add the name of the person that created the movie, or add a description or a display name or keywords. I'm going to take keywords and media and comma, trains. And title sync sound project, and we're going to call this model train project. So I can add those job annotations. Now when I go back down to here, and notice it can change by job, I can use those job annotations and build them into the video. I can pass through the source file metadata. That's metadata that's added inside Final Cut that's separate from the job annotations inside Compressor. Or I can say, remove all metadata and annotations. This is especially useful when you need to keep the source of the file secret. And you don't want to have any metadata that's added automatically by Final Cut go into the compressed file. Now, this remove setting is new. The include metadata from the source file is only active when use job annotations is active. This means that it combines the source metadata from Final Cut with the job annotations inside Compressor and builds it all into the movie that you're compressing. Again, let's just keep this really short. So we'll just drag this, grab the out, make it short, and go to here, delete this one. Yes, we want to delete it, and compress it. We'll go to compressed files. There's our train over bridge, and making it smaller. We see that there's our time code. We haven't changed that. Command I to show the inspector. There is my name. There's the keywords, media and trains, and it's called the titles that we dialed into it. So all the metadata that we added inside Compressor, we've now applied using this metadata, the job annotations and metadata. And again, if we select remove, none of that transfers to the compressed file. This was an excerpt of a recent PowerUp webinar showcasing the new features in Apple Compressor and Final Cut Pro. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.com/store and look for Webinar 318. By the way, when you need to stretch your training dollars, membership in our video training library saves you money and time. You can access all our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's almost 2,000 movies, hundreds of hours on a wide variety of subjects. Plus, premium members can download practice media and projects. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it multiple times each month. And for more information, visit larryjordan.com/membership. And thanks.